Hovertek. Just a button away.
In this tutorial, I will explain how to build TWRP for your Android devices in Hovertek's online TWRP builder. Compared to our previous tool, which was the Auto TWRP portal, this builds from source. So it creates a device tree for your device and then it builds off of that. And that gives us flexibility to tweak your device tree to introduce more features or fix bugs if need be. But right now it's still in beta testing, so you might encounter a couple of bugs. We are still working on all of that. Now, first of all, you need to find your way to the TWRP builder page. I need to have the files which you intend to build with. You should check our video, which will be posted here on this page, and also get familiar with the FAQ section if you have any questions. And if you need to speak to somebody to ask questions, just click on the chat button here and you can talk to a Hovertek rep. Okay, so quickly, let's gather the files I would need. This is the section you really have business with. So under image type, you need to know what kind of image type you are selecting. So it could be your boot image, it could be recovery image, or it could be boot image plus vendor boot. So the question is, which do you select? If you have a recovery image or recovery partition on your device and you have a recovery.img, that's what you select. Now, if you don't have a recovery image in your firmware and you have a boot image, you select that. But if you select boot image and you have an error and you happen to have a vendor boot also, so you try selecting both boot image and vendor boot. So I'll be using a device that combines all three, and there's another file called the patch.zip, which I will come to briefly soon. Next is the Android version. Currently supports 9 to 14. We'll introduce 5 to 8 soon, but this is what we are supporting right now. Here are the touch drivers. So what you usually do is at the FAQ section, if you run the build and you don't have touch screen, your touch screen doesn't work, you can check the FAQ section at the bottom for how to get the name of your touch drivers. So what you basically do is, when you get name of the touch drivers from the Droid hardware info or any APK you want to use to know the touch drivers names, you need to find the corresponding file in your device. So you could do this either by extracting your vendor.img, or you use a root file manager to search for that file name in your device to get the exact file name of your touch drivers. So I've noticed that if you have something with NVT in the name, it usually stands for Novatek. So you just search for Novatek and maybe that will help you find the name of the drivers. But just check the FAQ section at the bottom to know, to find out the name of the touch drivers. And if you have multiple drivers, you have them separated by comma. For example, you have a comma. Let's say I have for this device I'm using just one touch driver. But let's say they happen to be two touch drivers, and this is, let's say this is just bin. So I just put a space between both of them, and that is what I would input here. All right, once you know the name of your touch drivers, you just input them with a space. But I'm using just one, so that's what I'll be inputting. But I should check the FAQ section to know how to find out the name of your touch drivers. All right, usually from your vendor folder. TWRP size. Now, if you build a TWRP using our tool and it's too large, you can set this to yes when rebuilding so that it reduces the size. It does this by adding some flags which remove certain features from the TWRP build. And then there's custom flag. If you want to add any custom flag to your build, you can always add that. If you need a particular flag you don't see on this list, feel free to reach out to us and we can add that flag to this list. Okay, so let's commence build. I will be using an Android 13 device. Now, as you can see in my folder here, I'll be building with a boot image plus vendor boot. But then what is this folder? I want to demonstrate another file called patch.zip. You'll find more about patch.zip at the FAQ section somewhere here, where we reference patch.zip. But I'll show you briefly how to create that quickly. So let's say you want to move a particular set of files or folders to the recovery slash root folder in your device tree. What you need to do is you just need to zip all those files or folders you want to move to that particular directory and name that zip patch.zip. Now let me demonstrate. So let's say I have touch drivers in my first build, and I want to have the vendor folder in the recovery root folder. If you're familiar with device trees, you know what I'm talking about. In your recovery root folder, you want to have the vendor folder in there, and your vendor folder will in turn contain a firmware folder, which will in turn contain your touch drivers. So all you just have to do is, once you have the vendor folder, you just right click and you send to zip, and you name it patch. So there you have your patch.zip. So any file, if you have multiple folders you want to include in that directory, you just select all of them and then you right click and you send all to zip. So your patch.zip should contain everything directly. It shouldn't be in another. So you have multiple folders, multiple files listed in your patch.zip, and our tool will extract all of them into the recovery root folder for you. So this helps you with customization, especially for those who want to fix touch driver issues. So I'll be doing that. I'll be demonstrating that. So I'll be uploading my boot, my vendor boot, and my patch. My patch is going to extract this, my vendor folder, into the recovery/root directory in my device tree. Alright, so down to building, I have my files in place. So I would select image type. I'm going with boot image plus vendor boot. Android version, I'm going with 13. You can set your screen resolution if you have that, whether tablet or whatever. Make sure you find that out. But this is default that you're going to have in place. So for touch drivers, if you don't know your touch drivers or is your first build, you can leave that blank. It's optional, as you can see. Anything you see optional, it means it's fine to ignore it, and at least you have a build. But I know my touch drivers because I built and I didn't have touch. So I had to find out my touch driver names, and I just imputed that. I have just one touch driver, so I just input the name right here. So don't forget, you won't input the name that you see on whatever app you get that touch driver name from. It just gives you the blanket name. But what you need to input here is the actual file name of that touch driver. Alright, so please take note of that. FAQ section mentions how to do that. Default, when I built, I didn't have any issue with the size, so I'll just leave this fine. But if you're TWRP is larger than your partition, you just choose this to try to reduce the size a little more. Custom flags, yes, so you can just choose any custom flag you wish to impute. I don't think I really want to impute any flag for board demonstration. Let me just impute a harmless flag. Let's say CW exclude MTP. I'll just set this to false and then I add. So you can add multiple flags, just keep piling them up if you want, however you want. Add the value as you want, but I just want to stick with this. Alright, I don't need to add any flag, but I'll just leave this for demonstration. Okay, so the final step is now the upload part. So when you click upload, now if you are selecting just one file, you just need to select that one single file. But if you are selecting multiple files, you need to choose them all at once. And don't forget, I'm selecting three files, my boot plus vendor boot, which is a normal standard thing for my drop down. But because I also want to extract this vendor folder, which I've zipped to patch.zip, into the recovery/root directory in the device tree, I'll be selecting that also. I'm selecting all three files and then I'll choose open and then wait while it uploads. Alright, so file upload is done. It's now going to build the tree. So if you have an error at this point, it means maybe you should try a different image. If you've chosen just boot image, for example, maybe you should try your boot plus vendor boot if you do have. Or if you have a recovery, you should try to think around the kind of images which you are uploading to the tool. Alright, so I have my work ID. Take note of this, please. You can click this icon here to copy it. So this has copied to my clipboard. Make sure you save this work ID because this is how you track your build. So now I have my work ID. You just scroll down to this or track your build progress here, and you impute your work ID here. So if we need to tinker with your device tree or do anything around your build request, we are going to ask for your work ID. This is how we track it. So please make sure you keep this. And I should also mention that we don't retain your device tree for forever. Currently, we keep it for just a week. After 1 week, we clear it from our file system and our database. Not our database, really. We still keep track of your build anyway, but we delete your device tree. So please, if you need to download or reach out to us for any issues, do that within a week because we can't retain your files forever. So currently I can see I'm number 2 on the queue, so you just wait. It takes just a couple of minutes once your own build starts. But pending then, I can't see how many people you find on the queue. So once it gets to your turn, within a couple of minutes your build is done and then you can download. So I'll just keep checking. While you are waiting for your build, you can look through the FAQ section. So there might be some other changes which might not be captured in this video. So please look out for the FAQ section and feel free to reach out to us via any of our chat platforms or the forum for clarification or support around this. So you just keep running the check. You can decide to close the page and come back. It's not like it's locked to your current session. So just come back later and just keep tracking your build. And you can always download once it is done. Alright, so you see it says we are currently building your TWRP, so you just hold on and keep checking. Usually from this point it takes a couple of minutes depending on a couple of factors, but just a couple of minutes though. All right, so it says my build was successful, download now. So what you just do is to click this link and let me just open it in a new direct in a new tab. You just click this link and then you can go ahead and download. And that will start downloading your file. Alright, so that's how to build TWRP for your Android device using OverText Online TWRP Builder. So if you have any encounter any bugs or have any suggestions or contributions, please reach out to us via the live chat.